Hello guys, and welcome back to another Emcrater tutorial. Today what we're going to be covering is that cake tutorial. It's lost a few different votes, more than three I think now. What we're going to do is just cover that, get that out of the way, and then we can have some new content that we can basically vote for. So I made this cake. It sounds like slime. I have no idea why it sounds like slime. I didn't really look up the sound for the cake itself, so it sounds like slime. So we have a few different parts of the cake itself. If we go under, this will make it a little bit easier to see what's going on. So we have the bottom of the cake here. We have the side one and side two. So this is the sides that basically are part of the cake, but are on different sides there. And then we have these two sides, which are separate files for textures as well. And then we have the top of the cake. So that's pretty straightforward. If we eat the cake, then we get a little bit of saturation. As you can see on the food bar, it fills up when we eat the cake a little bit, and when we wait a few seconds for it to heal us, we can eat some more and we'll heal some more, and then the cake basically destroys itself. So that's basically how the cake works. We have a total of four textures and something like seven models. So let's hop into Emcrater and I'll show you how. So again, like I was saying with the textures, we have the bottom, the side one, and eaten side. So the eaten side shows the inside of the cake at the top there, and the regular side is just regular texture for the outside for the rainbow section. And then we have the other sides, which are the purple and red sides for the actual cake, and then we also have the top of the cake. For models, we have a whole bunch of different block states for the actual models. We have a total of seven of them. So we'll need to import them. Again, they're pretty straightforward. You just need to align the side one with the side one texture, side two with the side two texture, and then the top and bottom is pretty straightforward and easy to set up. So once you've done all that and got your textures imported, we can move on to the actual procedure for the cakes. But first, before we do that, we'll move into the settings for the cake, and then we'll cover the procedure and how that all works. So let's take a look at the rainbow cake, the first state, which is just rainbow cake. We have set our particle texture, we've set our state to zero, and we have set our sizes to this size right here. So that's all set up, and if we move over to the properties, this is why it's sounding like slime. I'm not sure exactly what cake actually sounds like, oddly enough, so I'm not sure which one to choose, so it's just slime. The hardness and resistance is set to 0.5 each. That's basically all there is in this particular setup. We have it to not drop itself, so it'll be destroyed when it's broken, and we don't have a specific tool to be able to destroy the cake itself. Moving on, what we're going to do is go to advanced properties. You can just leave the tick rate at 10. It doesn't really matter, we don't really need it, so that's fine. I've set the color on map to air, which is just one down from the default, and that will just basically show that there isn't any cake there on the world. We don't need MBT data for this particular tutorial, and we're not using Forge Energy Storage or Fluid Storage, so we can move on. We only have one procedure, and that's linked to all of the states, which is, I think it's linked to all the states. It should be. It's linked for the actual right-click event. And generation, we're not generating it. Let's go into state one, and we'll just confirm that the settings. So moving on to the first state, or the state two, I guess. It's technically state one, but the only thing that you're going to need to change is the rainbow cake and the bounty blocks on that page. You can leave the settings as the same as your first state, so you can basically just duplicate it. All this can stay the same. All the other settings are the same. So when you duplicate your model, all you really need to do after is update this model, or update the model, and then update your boundary box, and then you're set to go. All right, so let's cover the procedure, get that out of the way. So the first thing that we're doing is we're testing if the current food level of the provided entity is less than 20, because 20 is how much the player has. Then what we're doing is we're setting the food level to get food level plus one, which basically increases it by one. And then what we're doing is we're changing the block state depending on what version of the cake we're actually viewing it as. So it starts with 00, or just a regular cake, and then it will turn it into cake 1, and then it'll test for cake 1, so the next time that we right-click on the cake, it'll be running it from this one, and then it will update the model to cake 2, and then it'll test for cake 2, and then it'll test for, or basically replace it with cake 3, and so on until it reaches the last state, which is the 6th state, which is technically the 7th model, and it's going to just test for that model, and if that's true, then it's going to break and spawn the particles. So again, it's going to test for every state in order, so from the full state to the empty state, and then it's going to change the model to the next state for the 6th of the states, and then the last state's just going to break the block. So that's basically how that's all set up. I will show you how to create the beginning of this stuff. So let's head into flow control, and we'll grab a if statement, and then what we need a dark blue operator. I'm going to place that right down right here. We are then going to go and right click on the equal sign, and then we're going to go less than, and then we're going to set the food level, which we need to go to, I think, player procedures, and then get food level, and then we're going to test for a number, so we need to go math, and then we're going to place it down here, and then we're going to set this to 20, which is going to test for the less than 20, so anything 19 and under, and then what we're going to do is set the food level, so we need to go back to player procedures, and we're going to scroll down until we see set food level, so it should be, set food level right here, and then we're going to actually just move that number down. We're going to get a math operator, place that right down here. We're going to set this number to 1, and then we're going to just duplicate get food level, and we're going to place that right in here. So when we have that part set up, all we need to do is go and create another if statement. So go back to flow control, grab your if statement, and then what we need to do is test for the blocks. We're going to go to logic, grab a yellow operator, and then what we're going to do is go to blocks, scroll down to the bottom, and then there is get block at. We're going to place that right down here, and then we're going to go Minecraft components, we're going to get the box that allows us to test for the block, and we're going to set our first block state. And then what you want to do is you want to replace that block, so we're going to just click on block procedures again, grab a block, replace block at, and we're going to set this to our second state. And then you want to actually add more of these states, so you want to click on the gear icon, and then you want to just add a total of 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then what you want to do is just update these options. So this would be the 2nd, and then you want to select your 3rd, and then you want to duplicate this again, and then you're going to set this to your 3rd, and then you're going to duplicate that. I'm going to set this to the 4th, and then you're going to duplicate it again, and you're going to set this to your 4th. So now it's basically replacing it to your 4th model. It's testing for the 4th model, and then you want to replace it to your 6th, so like this. And we're going to replace this with our 6th model. And we're going to test for a 6th model, and then we're going to do that again, so like that, and then we're going to do this, and then we're going to replace that with our final model, and, or pardon me, that should be 5, that should be 4, 3, 2, and 1, and that should be our default one, so this should replace it with our final model, and then we're going to test for our final model, and then what we're going to do is go to block procedures, and then we're going to replace the block, or pardon me, break the block with particles, which we're going to select this one right down here, move block at, and spawn break particles. So we're going to place that right down there. So that's all there is to the procedure. All you need to do is link it up with the actual system like this, and then you're good to go. So hopefully you guys found this tutorial helpful. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, rate the video, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out.